Ooh, cute. It's like little lumpy thing. Okay. Left mouse button. It's often useful to know what's going on around you. You can rotate the camera by holding down the left mouse button in space and moving around. Yay! Whoo! Okay, I look like I'm in a giant seed. That's not even like a seed. That's like a little tulip bulb or something there. Look at that. It's kind of rocky too. You can zoom in and out using the scroll wheel. Try it now. Wee-hoo! Whoa! Wow! Wee-hoo! Wait, where'd I go? There I am. Click next when you've mastered the camera controls. That's close enough to mastering. The other main tool for finding and interacting with the nearby objects is the overview.
The overview.
The overview is a list style window you see on the right of your interface. This shows all the things in the immediate area, as well as important landmarks across your whole star system. By default, it is sorted by distance, showing the closest items to you at the top of the list. Click the next button when you're comfortable with the overview.
Okay, why not?
Clicking on the overview entry will show you that item in the selected item panel immediately above the overview. Here you can see a small image of the item you have selected, along with some brief information and a row of buttons representing the common ways to interact with it. Click the next button when you inspect the selected item panel.
No object selected. Okay, good.
Every object in space has a special icon.
Why am I flying without knowing where I'm going? Just out of curiosity. Like, am I gonna crash into something?
Every object in space has a special icon known as a bracket. You can see these brackets in the leftmost column of the overview. Each type of bracket represents a different type of object. Broken squares are ships flown by capsuleer pilots like yourself. Crosses are those ships not flown by capsuleers. If they are red, you may shoot them.
Ooh, that should be, sounds like fun.
Stations have continuous square brackets. Click next when you have familiarized yourself with the brackets.
Square bracket, not square bracket. Okay. Do-do-do-do. I don't see any X's though, so I can't shoot anything. Do-do. Come on. Why aren't you getting next? Am I stuck? Am I stuck? Am I stuck? Am I supposed to click on stuff? No, I don't want to approach it. I just want to see it. I want to hit next. Oh, there we go.
Now you've mastered your basic camera controls. You need to use your warp drive to travel to your mission objective. To do this, locate the agent missions listing in the upper left corner of your screen.
Vlump. Covering the basics.
Click on the current mission name covering the basics and then select warp to location.
Warp to location.
This will engage your warp drive, a system that allows you to travel across star systems extremely quickly.
Ooh, that does look very quickly. Wow, it looks like all the planets are going down a toilet. It's the space toilet. Look at that. Anyways,
this will engage your drive extremely quickly. You click next when you start the warp destination.
Yep.
Once you've landed at the mission location, I'm going to teach you a few more basic controls. The left mouse button is used for selecting things, pressing buttons, dragging and dropping other command functions.
Whoa, this looks like a weird little laser space death thingy. That looks very dangerous.
The right mouse button is used for bringing up contextual menus. The contextual menu gives you a list of options which changes depending.
Why am I going up all of a sudden?
Changes depending on where you right click.
How do I control where I'm actually driving?
Click next when you're ready to learn how to board a starship.
Okay.
Your ship is waiting for you to board. Right click the ship and click next.
Okay, so that's my ship over there. This is a rookie ship. So, and then board the ship. Whoa, okay. Did I just board it? Okay, this is weird looking. Interesting. Not really what I was expecting for my first ship, but okay. Okay, I boarded it. Now what?
Once you have boarded your ship, look around and find the acceleration gate in space. Right click on the acceleration gate.
Okay, that looks like the acceleration gate then, apparently. and then select activate the gate. Okay. You should see the activate automatically warp to next area, blah blah. When you click next, when you activate the accelerated gate. Ooh, funky music. I got funky spit. Oh yeah. Driving around in space. Oh yeah. Whoa. Why am I turning around now? Did I just control something?
The approach command allows you to approach any selected object in space. Once you have arrived inside the final area of the site, you should try it out.
Okay, so I guess see the structure. By select the structure by clicking on it. Okay. Approaching Galente Core. Once it's selected, right click on the structure and then select approach. Approach. Oops, sorry guys. To begin moving
controls the structure, you will continue to approach until harmlessly bounce off it.
Okay.
You'll never take damage from running into a ship or do other things.
Oh, that sounds good for a person like me.
Click next when you start the process.
Okay, I did. Whoa, there we go.
Your ship has the capability to access items from structures and wrecks and storage ships. Inspect the structure or wreck.
Right click on it, click open cargo. I guess you're not. Oh, wait, here, I open cargo. Okay.
Every ship has a cargo of both which you can use to carry items around with you. You move the contents from the container into in space, like the one you just opened, into your cargo hold, just click on the loot all button.
Okay, loot all. I like that one. That's always my favorite one.
This will move everything into your ship and show you the contents of your cargo hold.
Okay, I've looted it all.
Once you've looted the object, your work here is done.
Yes.
You should head back to the station and complete the mission and accept your rewards. Locate the station again in the overview. Remember that it is a continuous... It is a continuous square bracket and is named after the system you're in.
Okay.
Once you find it, right-click on it and dock.
Okay, I'm guessing it's this one because it's the only square bracket I see. So... guess warp to within... Do you find it? Dock. Okay. I still like this music. This is epic music here. Why am I doing like a little fishtail thing? I guess I can't get around this thing very easily. Sorry about that, guys.
The ship you're currently flying in is classified as a
rookie ship.
If you ever enter a station with no ships available, you'll be given a free
rookie ship.
So you're never stuck without a proper transport. These free ships always come with the basic weapon and a basic mine laser, but they're not very powerful. The ship you're in right now doesn't have any basic equipment, but you'll be given it shortly. Click next when you've docked and re-entered your station.
Okay. Dock. Moving on.
Once you've docked and opened the agents tab on the station menu, click the start conversation button, open the music, blah 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 blah.
Aurora.
Complete the mission.
Yay! I have completed the mission! Yay!
Huzzah! Well, guys, I think that's all I'm going to do for this Fan Friday on Eve. If you guys are interested in the game, you can get yourself a free trial of it. It is still pay to play, but from the looks of things, it's probably going to be worth it. I'll probably do a little bit later on when I actually get some fun, epic stuff going on. Maybe even film one of these classic giant space battles, who knows. Anyways, hope you guys enjoyed. This is Macattack signing off. Have a great weekend. Bump, 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 bump